Hey guys, and welcome to part 2 of my 1000 subscriber special. Now then, in today's episode on Thornton Farm, we are going to be doing a bit of mowing at the castle. Now, they rejected us last time. They thought that it didn't need doing. So they called us back again, and that's a bit quieter as well. And they'd like it doing. So today we are just going to be using this rear mower, as the Valtra that we have on demo hasn't got a 3-point linkage on the front, unfortunately. I believe it is a Grassmen logo sort of tractor, which can have a front loader there, the brackets there, jewels, all sorts of stuff. It's got IC control. It's a fairly nice tractor, 38 mile an hour speed. So I thought this should hopefully be a fairly good tractor to use. I kind of like the Valtra. Never really used them in one of my videos before. So I thought now is probably the time. So we are just going to use the back mower, like I said, as it we have no 3-point linkage on the front. It might take a bit longer, however. Shouldn't be too bad. Straighten it up slightly. I think when I was backing in, part of it caught on that other mower, which is stopping me from doing this straight like I normally attach it. Oh, let's do this properly. I'm going to try to be fairly realistic as well, as this tractor does have doors that you can open and stuff. Okay. Oh right, it went for the one at the back, did it? Just put on four-wheel drive in that, just so I can get that out of the way. There we go. Oh, well. That was odd. I'm going to have to put that back in now. Sorry, is this connected to anything? No, it's not. Well, hopefully this will be able to move that power just enough so I can just back it up a bit more. Alright, that kind of looks quite good on the back there. Yeah, slightly annoying this. If that happens, if we move it over this way a bit more, hopefully we shouldn't have that again. Up a bit more, there we go. Right. Turn that off, we'll jump back into our Valtra. I think this is all that we need today. However, this is an hour long video, and there were talks about the National Trust, is it National Trust? I don't know. The castle, they would like some more trees, so we do have this tree planter which we may get round to planted some trees at some point in this episode, maybe. Yeah, hopefully. It's quite good. Right, we have to fold this up now, do we? It'll be nice to see how this operates on the road, as I know when I had this mower on... Oh, that's annoying, that lock doesn't work. When I had this on our New Holland, the mower would just, yeah, it just go about everywhere. There's no easy way of doing anything. So you'd be driving along, and the mower, let's see if I can do it now. Seems to be rather stable, but the mower would go inside itself. So that bar there, that would go through that yellow plastic there, I think, yeah, just slightly, and yeah, it'd make the whole thing look incredibly unrealistic. So let's put beacons on. It's a nice little drive down to the castle, and plus we do have the whole property to do, so even the farmer's field there, we spoke to them and they would like it cut in, It's a fairly large job, this. So we get paid up a lot, which is good. I think it's about £5,000 to £7,000, depending on how much we can get done. And this field here needs doing, that one there, and the one a bit further needs doing. But we'll just go up to the main area here for now. And with this, there's also some trees which I could do with clearing if we get around to that today. So that might be good. Let's glance mod quickly. We'll get up there into the car park, because we're back in. Like it to be, have a bit more information. What's it, left alt M for more. I'll get that level 0, and that should be quite good. Anyway, I see on this track, so you've got the door there, back window. I think that's it. I've had a look around. We've got more radios. Well, the radio in our class tractor, that works, and the aircon and that, but it doesn't in here. Yeah, that's it. Nothing down there. However, the interior of this looks quite good. And although the pictures aren't the greatest, this, well, they do look like they've been taken from an actual tractor, which is quite nice. Bit dodgy. The way that the colour isn't quite right, but I mean, you can't get perfect mods, as they take a very long time. But I'm quite happy with this. It's a nice tractor. I think I found this on Mod Hoster. I just typed in Valtra tractor, and it was on Mod Hoster. So yes. Which field should we do first? If we do this field, we might have to open that gate. What side is this on? So, it'd be better if we do start from down here actually, and just go around in a circle. That gate's open, so we might have to close one of them. Hopefully people can still get it. There's two gates there, so that's okay. We just park this here. Buttons. Right. Should we unfold this and we'll get going? So, we've sort of hired this tractor really. Got it on demo. Hired it, I don't know. But yeah, it's quite nice to have something different from New Holland, because our company here is very New Holland orientated. It should be class really, because we have a class dealer, we have an actual class dealership in this area. So should have gone with class maybe, but service, you can get the tractor serviced, which is good. Don't really need much more than that. And plus, one of the other workers that we have is a mechanic. So he's done agricultural mechanic or whatever the course is, so he can take care of that. Is there a wall there or something, or is it just that hedge that this is catching up? It's just the hedge, so we've got to be careful of that, I thought. Collision's a bit too far out for my liking on there. We go fairly slowly around the edge here, and we can get it done. We'll do that little bit a bit later, I think. We might even bring down our little New Holland track to use that a bit. Should be quite good. I mean, as well, we are doing this the same day that we did our other property, as I think the other National Trust or English Heritage I think it might be National Trust, this one. But yeah, we are doing this the same day as we did the gardens and that. So that's quite good. I think if we end up doing all the National Trust properties, it says only two here in the area. If we do them on the same day, then it should be quite good. Have we been paid for that one yet? I'm not sure. We might have to just start taking note of what we've been paid to do. And if we have an actual price list sort of thing. But we sort of offer bespoke solutions here, so there's no property exactly the same as this, so we offer bespoke things. However, the council houses mostly the same size gardens. We do like a medium garden, a small garden, and a large, and then once it goes past large, we sort of treat them as commercial properties with the size of them. I'm looking forward to when we have Valtra in FS17. We're going to have some really, really good models of Valtra tractors in there. They're quite nice, I do like them. As well, all the local farmer wanted us to do here was just cut it, because part of this is his land. I think next field on past there, that's his land. However, he knows that we're doing this today, so he's going to pay us for doing that as well. He's made an agreement with the owners of this property, the National Trust, and the amount that he gets paid, we would get paid. However, we are going to pay him a slight amount of money to take away the grass, which he would originally do. We'll sort it out some way. As someone did say as well in the comment section, that you just leave the grass where it is, like this. It seems to be a lot of grass. I don't know if we will do that or not. Might do. I know on this part and the other part, on the farmer's part, he's going to take that away. So he can put that in one of his silage clamps maybe. Or bale it, whatever he wants to do with it. It's not the best quality grass. There's much better around here. I mean, it's just an extra bit. If he needs to use it for a bit of hay, then he can do. Go slow around that bit. That's not... Oh, it looks fairly flat. It's not actually that flat. It's going much slower there. For example, there. That's a bit of a pain. Let's do a bit of in-cab in a minute. As well, there is, and I think there's a notes mod for Farmington, which I have had actually, but I took it out as it wasn't working properly, but I think that was me not knowing how to use it, so I've read up on it now, and I'm going to put it back in. So it was quite a nice little mod to have, so you can make notes in that. For example, I could say all the properties that I've done on a certain date or day. Get paid at a certain time. So at the end of the day, that is when we most likely will get paid. Actually, there's some dark clouds over there. Let's have a quick look at the weather. Oh, so today it's good. Tomorrow it's good as well. Saturday it's quite good. Sunday it's rainy, which could mean that on the morning of Monday the grass will be fairly wet, so we won't be able to do much more than that. Well, actually, I have noticed it's been absolutely chuckling bad outside when they've been going around places. I've seen actual commercial companies cutting grass when it's been pouring down with rain. So you know, if someone wants you, then I suppose you've got to cut it, haven't you? But just so it doesn't clog up mowers and that when it's wet. Especially if it's long grass like this, I wouldn't really do it when it's wet. I can imagine the inside of there getting rather clogged. Yeah, going back to the weather, what was it? Monday, yeah, a bit wet. Tuesday, it's sunny. Wednesday, kind of cloudy. but we can live with that, because clouds, it's all right. Rain, we can't deal with. We don't really want rain. So we're a quarter of the way in now to the video. Might not get all this done. On the other hand, we do have another tractor at our disposal, so we might be able to do a bit of follow me mod action there and have it offset so that we can do that. It'd be quite cool. Just bring down the other New Holland. We don't have course play at the moment. I did take it out. I don't think course play can actually do cutting grass. It would be nice as well if in next generation of farm sims, so FS17, that your hired worker can actually cut grass. Sometimes it's a bit annoying not being able to cut grass. If you've got a huge field and you've got other stuff to be getting on with, it'd be nice if you could hire someone to cut the grass. But yeah, I think I'm going to be getting hired to do the grass cutting. There's, I think that's something they've added in, like, instead of the missions, it's sort of contracts work. So I'll probably do a series on that. Quite good, hopefully. This series, people like it, which is quite nice. It's one of the more popular series on this channel, I think. What was it? The snow plowing. That was fairly popular, I thought. Anyway, that was when the channel was kind of small. So yeah, it's quite nice to finally have a really quite popular series. For example, everyone and their dog's doing Knavesworth Farm, just normal. Everyone's doing Thornton, so I thought, do a bit of a change, do a landscaping series. People kind of like it, so that's good. So what, do you guys have any ideas for any other jobs that I could do in this series? For example, I've done the main, I think I've done all the big properties now once I've finished this. So I can get that. For example, Stonehenge we've done. The castle we would have done. What else is there? The gardens we've done. Yeah, we've kind of done the majority of the main areas now. Once we're done, I'll have to come back and do this part again, maybe. I don't know. We can go back and revisit some of the places as well, because by the time we've done every single place on here, it'll be time to go back and start over again. Cutting. I think we started the pub, but I did that the other day. But they need their grass cutting a lot faster than some of the other people on here. For example, these guys, they have it cut six or seven times a year. So when it gets really quite long, then we get called in. Because it's not all like the gardens where you'll have people just about on here having a picnic or something. It's not really that sort of place to be doing that. It is kind of farm property, really. But the castle own it, so we cut grass. So it's a National Trust contract that we have with them. So yeah. I think I might have to bring in the New Holland, because this might take a bit longer than I thought. For example, we could have had this, what I've done so far, done in half the time. So we will send, we'll just teleport back over to our yard here. I think one of the New Hollands is there actually. I'll jump in this one. I will hook up the front and rear mower, and then we'll be able to put them on follow me, whatever it is. Follow me, yeah, I think. Pull forward a bit more. Put PTO on. It's slightly annoying that the PTO is just not hanging there. For example, on this, mower here. PTO would probably just be hanging down there. It'd be good if in FS17 you can sort of see out the back windows and lean out. I think that'd be quite good. The door doesn't open, that's annoying. Right, let's get going down to this property. We give our Valtra a bit of a hand. Although the Valtra's nice, I don't think we will end up purchasing one, not because it hasn't got the front linkage. Unless I could find a mower like what I think we're having in FS17, where you've got the big butterfly mowers and then that little mower can just go in between. Unless I can find one of them, we're not going to have the Valtra, I don't think. It's a nice tractor, it's got a lot of power. Compared to this, let's just have a look actually. What we got here? Oh yeah, what the place we got there. This has got 212 horsepower, the Valtra's got 200 dead on, I think. A bit of a difference. But the Valtra's nice, I do like it. Glance mode is actually quite good. Oh, missed a turn it because it tells you what job it's doing. For example, Valtra's mowing, engine is on. Quite nice that. Be easier if we have this behind, I think. On the left hand side, maybe? Technically, I don't know actually. Whoa, I'm not even accelerating there. I'm just going. This thing is very difficult to control when the brakes aren't the best on it. So, if we just unfold this, we can see where we've got to be. So that sort of needs to be behind the tractor. That's what we want. Right offset meters. 4 meters. Behind distance 10, I think. Lower that, turn it on. Not doing a lot on there, do we? Might have to sort that out, I don't know. It's a bit too far over, so it's 4 metres we want, not 3. Ah, oh, that can't back up, can it? That's kind of annoying. So that, yeah, that's on the left, so that's why I did that. Just to get a bit more distance behind it, I think. That's why I did that. Yeah, it should be enough distance there. So the driving is not going to be as good because I've got to make it better, more easier for that tractor to follow. On the bigger field, we can try and sort it out. Which is halfway in. We finished this field yet, have we? Not the best there. That drive is not very good, is it? Just swerving about everywhere. Yeah, we'll have to come back and do these pieces, I think. Well, when I was out the other day, I did see Camp Challenger. It's quite nice. Doing a bit of cultivating. Oh, it's just the right offset, that's 3 meters. I've got to do this part here now. To be on the left. Hopefully I can do it all. Might be able to. It's a bit up here. Hopefully that's all that tractor needs to be. Yeah, that's good. So I've done this part now. The next part is over there, so the farmer's field. So if we just raise that up slightly, we might be able to get through here. Alright. Short left, we don't, I'm not mowing all the way down there, do we? That's the last thing. Which way are we going around? We'll start off at this bottom corner down here, I think. Go around in a sort of circle kind of fashion. We'll make the offset about 20 metres I think this time, or how far behind that other tractor is from this one. Just make it a bit easier. Never visited that farm. I might have to go around there at some point, see what equipment they've got. Tractor's all out there, isn't it? So far behind. I'm not sure if the farmer will take this grass actually, he might just leave it. So I mean, it's in the contract that they can leave it if they want, anyone that cuts the grass. For example, we have a contract and the farmer has a contract. And I forgot that that was swinging out like that. So yeah. Offset behind, we want it 25 metres, that'll do. No, yeah, that should do, hopefully. Let's go. Hopefully this works. Mow is on, so that's good. It says it's mowing. Right, it recognises that following mod's on there. That tractor is significantly slower than this, actually. Okay. What is it? About a mile or an hour slower? Which we'll probably notice, actually. Yes, this field just stretches all the way along that road there, all the way up to the road that you turn in on. It's a fairly large field. It does mean that less turning as well, so we can get the job done quicker. As well, the Chrome Big M, I think it is, we may end up hiring that in for some of the very, very big jobs. For example, here, instead of using these mowers, that Chrome Big M would be very helpful because it can put it into rows. I mean, all we'd ever do is we'd ask the farmer if he wants the grass. If not, then we'll hire in that forage wagon. We will put it in heat in our yard. So yeah. I like this grass mow. Nice if you could see it from the inside there. gonna end up crashing at some point just looking about this tractor everywhere. Number plate there. Grassmen are quite good to watch, I think. Some of them. I haven't got the DVDs, just watch the little things on YouTube. Seem quite good. I was debating actually as well whether to do this series, this landscaping or a grassman sort of series. To get a map with just tons and tons of maize and grass on. Just do that. But I thought, I don't know. I decided not to in the end. I don't really know why. If you guys would like a grassman sort of series, then please say so in the comments. As I could probably, the Massey Ferguson, might be that model in Farm Sim. Is it Donkey Contracts, I think, I don't know. They've got a Massey Ferguson, which the woman drives, I think. Valtra, well, must have. So this has got Grassmen logos all over. We could do sort of like Grassmen kind of series. Possibly a multiplayer series. Because it's not just one person. It's tons of people. That'd be quite good. I might have to organise something like that. It'd be like it could just be the field. See how it goes with just one field, doing one field, but yeah, I don't know. What do you guys like to watch, that sort of thing? I'm going to have to watch the steering on this, because I'm just going to miss out that complete corner. I'm going to have to go back and do it at some point. I'm going to end up doing that, aren't I? Just going into the other swath, which is slightly annoying. Try to keep it tight to that swath. Not completely over it like I am in there. Maybe a bit half and half on the corners, maybe. I could perhaps film it like one of the Grassmen videos. So I've loads of people in the tractors and that. Oh, I forgot that these tractors can get dirty as well. Quite nice to see a different texture on the tyres actually, compared to the whole tyre just going brown or grey, whatever kind of dirt texture they've gone for. I see there's sort of patches on them. Quite realistic actually. Unless you go for a massive deep mud pool, you don't have just the complete tyre get muddy. Anyway, going back to the Grassmen series idea, I could film it like I am. Might mention that on FS UK. Because we could plan that. I'll see if anyone's got a Grassmen sort of operation going. And film that, I think that'd be quite good. Take a bit of editing, I think. But perhaps do some time lapses and stuff in it. Stick the camera in one position. Time lapse it. Can't reverse, can I? That's annoying. I would like to be able to reverse with Follow Me mod. I'll have to take this tractor for a proper test drive in a minute, once we've finished this field. The other fields don't really matter because they aren't our responsibility, because we've got gates around them. And I believe, not this farm, but the other one owns them. Our fields. This is 14. Yeah, 17 and 18 they're owned by the other farmer. We are not employed to do them. It's just this one, as you can see it from the road and the castle, and the other one. As that is on the castle's property, really. around the castle that doesn't need doing, but the trees could do with clearing. However, it's not before 9 o'clock in the morning, so there's people about, so it'd be unsafe if we did start to fell some trees. And beacons off a bit, we don't really need them in the field. Nice as well to see this completely white tractor go a lot darker with the mud. I'll have to find a mud pool, I think there's one in the forest, and see what this is like in the forest. Because we don't have to buy this tractor if we were, we need some money first, but we did end up buying a voucher. We don't necessarily have to use it for the mowing, we can use it for the trailers and that. But we'll have to see, because there is a horsepower recommendation on those IT runner trailers. Because I think it's PTO driven. I think that, yeah. You don't want an underpowered tractor on that. So it's basically just got the normal trailer, then it can't operate with the hook lift like it's meant to. I think as well we can leave the odd bits here, here and there, on the corner back up there we're going to have to sort it. I think actually once that gets a bit straighter up there we can just go straight across it. It's actually quite good, straighten out this field just as one long strip that we've got to do. How realistic I do the grass men as well. Don't know if I had to find some Irish people. So I think there is a couple of Irish contractors that they've done grass men with. Don't know if I found some Irish people with an Irish accent that would be willing to do grass men. Well, it'd make for quite a good video. That's me thinking that though. These 1 hour videos, if you go really well, they can go really terribly, and people watch about half an hour and then they go. That'll be the last thing I need. So, well, tomorrow there's not going to be a video because, yeah, I've spent so much time on these videos. I'd like to have a bit of time to just sort everything out. For example, that's why there wasn't a video a few days before these ones. These took a while to sort out really. 2 hours of recording, you got editing, rendering, uploading, stuff like that. It does actually take a while to upload a YouTube video. Almost done this. Little bits on the corner, I think we can leave them. And as long as the grass is shorter in the majority of the places, it should be okay. People don't use this land either, so we are going to crash. Oh, the horn's still pathetic. There we go. All I do know is actually that tractor will just come back on itself here. So it will get the majority of, well, it'll get all of that. No, I don't have any comments to read out either. Let's have a look actually, just in case some haven't popped up in my notifications. Same video. Oh, Oh, there's a couple of comments. I'll get them up on YouTube. I can read them properly without having half the comment disappear. Oh, this is a problem. That's going to come on itself. Oh, they're going to collide. Do these corners here, and then that will probably be this field done. And we've got 20 minutes left of this video. That's plenty of time to do some stuff and possibly get them trees down if we shut this park or this property down, part of it down for a while. It'd be funny just to watch that follow this path that this is setting. please get there before. Say, why is that going in a circle? That's a, yeah, we don't actually know where we're going. Well, it seems to be done. Raise this up. Can be the thumbnail for this video, I think. Once we've got the other tractor in the shop, we're done there actually, we don't need that. I'll go facing the castle partly, I think. This tractor will be the one sort of in the background, Valtra will be in front. Go for a long walk back to the tractor. In fact, I can just drive with that door open. Get a bit of fresh air in. Well, I was slightly disappointed that the window there doesn't open. Kind of expecting that to. Yeah, it doesn't. So. Bit disappointing. Got a photo shot there. So it's time to do a bit of wizardry. GS toggle helps if it's in lowercase. Yeah, where are we? Print screen. Pause break. That is that done. There we go. Right. Let's pop this in, follow me. The tractor's still running. Let's jump out anyway. So offset to be nothing, that to be 10 metres behind. 5 metres a bit too close for comfort there. That's connected. Let's go. I think we can turn off this road down here. That's quite nice to get this job done. I didn't really want to do this property. It's just, it's sort of one of the more difficult ones, as you've got all the different changes in terrain height, so some of the grass doesn't get cut. And it's more field-like as well. I don't really enjoy just doing field. I prefer a bit of a challenge, like obstacles. Like the playground and the things at the pub, the benches. This tractor as well, top speed 38 mile an hour. It's a decent tractor. This is one of the reasons why I would have got it, was because of the speed. It's a bit like the Fendt 1050 that I've got in whatever map it is. Thornton, I think. No, Knavesville, this is Thornton. Idiot. Yeah, that's got a top speed of 38 mile an hour, so it's quite a nice tractor to use. Oh, that stopped there. Whoa, that was toppling over. It's not made for this speed, is it? Try not to put that in the hedge. I've got to lower this, haven't I? Be good if you could use these buttons to lower and raise at all. Oh, there's not actually a PTO on there, is there? This tractor has got a PTO, hasn't it? I'm just being completely stupid. Right, okay. That is surgically connected to our tractor. Why won't it disconnect? Everything's disconnected there, right? Attach what we're attaching. We're attaching that. Then connect PTO, that's X. Let's disconnect the PTO. In fact, let's connect it up and see what this does. So that won't disconnect like that. So put it down, disconnect it. Oh, I've broken the tractor. In real life. Oh, that's disconnected. Isn't it like a collision part, I think, that this is still connected to? No. Those clips are released. So there is a PTO. I'm not just going crazy, am I? Why does that raise up though? That should stay down. Alright, so that's definitely disconnected because the hydraulic's good. Down. I don't know. Because that did come off earlier when I was trying to. Okay. We'll have to leave that for now. 10 minutes left of this video. Highly unrealistic taking off this front. In fact, no, we won't do that. We'll see if the telehandler can move. Off there, I'll have to move the pickup maybe. Is the telehandler in this part of the shed? No, it's in this one. Door open. Don't need pallet flocks or anything. Let's see if we can do it with a bracket here. Now, this isn't the way which you should do it. Fuck, let's see if we can put pallet flocks on it and just lift the whole thing up. I'll have to dance around this pickup though. Oh, it's last thing I need. This is why I like this telehandler, just the reaction speed of these hydraulics here. Right, let's see what we can do here. That's... still connected to the tractor. They're going to destroy our mower in a minute. That shouldn't be connected to the tractor. That is physically disconnected. Don't do this at home, guys. You could have this fall on your head. Whoa, it doesn't like the lag here, does it? Oh well, just going to reset it before we can take a ride in it. Right, let's drive forward slightly. Let's reset it. No, it's there, that's good. Right, let's go for a test drive in this tractor. So you can also get jewels on it, I don't know if I said that. I think I did, but oh well. Let's find a bit of mud. I'd like to see this thing dirty and its dirty texture. No mud about anyway. Maybe some here. And this farm. As well, the dirt and terrain mud thing, where you've got the the mud which you can drive through. I'm surprised the author didn't make it so that when you drive through water, it makes your vehicle slightly cleaner. And yeah, I'm not entirely sure how much harder that'd be just to sort of, it'd basically copy the code but reverse what you do to make it dirty. This isn't a farm, is it, that we go to? It is. Just down the road is a bit of mud, I think. I'm not used to this. Turn there completely. 38 mile an hour in this tractor we can get up to down these country roads. If this is how fast this tractor goes in real life, this would be why grassmen use it, or the contractors, because they can get around fairly quickly. So that is the farm that I was at. Right, I know where there was a bit of mud in that forest, so we'll go up there for a bit. The last 7 minutes 15 seconds of the video, roughly. I'm a bit annoyed that I couldn't get the mud patch working in there that I added in. That's just sort of just aesthetics now. Well, this is why you don't move fast down a country road, because the whole cab just shakes about everywhere. I don't make you sick though, actually. It's the rest of it moves. Let's see, yeah, it moves from side to side slightly. Turning into the forest somewhere. Just here. Could use this as a forestry tractor actually, or have the verge cutter on this possibly. Oh, trees have grown through our shed. Oh, nice. Is that 100% dirty there? Oops. I accelerated a bit faster than I thought it would do in this mud. Glass doesn't get dirty. Is this right? So that's two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, diff lock. could see that cab moving there. Oh, it's quite nice, this. I do like it. So yeah, that is it for this 1,000 subscriber special part 2. That's all there is for the 1k special. When we hit 2k, I might do another video. I don't think it will be too long actually until we do that. Because we're at like 150 subscribers, something like that now, I think. 130, I think. I don't know. We're rising fairly quickly though. I think I calculated it. At the moment, it's about 10 subscribers a day. So I'm quite pleased with that. We can send this back to dealership now. And I'll do that in a minute. Once we've tidied everything away, I'll do a tidying off screen. But yeah, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share this video, as it really does help me out. And I'll catch you in the next one. Goodbye.